Cranial nerve 10 is the vagus nerve, vagus, vagabond, the wanderer. And it's described as such because it has such a long course and a really broad distribution. There are multiple components to the vagus nerve. We have a motor component, which is both somatic and visceral, and in this case, parasympathetic. And there are multiple sensory modalities. We have a somatic sensory modality, a special sensory modality, and a visceral sensory modality. And if I turn on my pen, here we go. Here is the vagus. It's coming down from the base of the skull. It's running along the carotid artery. It comes down in front of the aortic arch. And then part of it, this is the part that's going to head on down throughout the thorax and abdomen. And then part of it actually bends back around and comes behind the aortic arch and comes back up into the larynx. This is called the recurrent laryngeal nerve. You don't need to know that right now, but if you ever have thyroid surgery, make sure your surgeon knows about the recurrent laryngeal nerve, because you can squish it and then that's bad. So again, this is the vagus nerve right along here. So the motor component of the vagus, the somatic motor, goes to the striated muscle of the pharyngeal constrictors back here. This is skeletal muscle, and it's the upper part of where you begin to swallow in the back of the pharynx, and it's continuous with the esophagus below. So, and it also innervates the palatoglossus muscle, which is at the back of your mouth, at the back of the oral cavity. You may hear the term branchial motor. Now, I'm not a fan of this term, but it's based on the fact that these muscles here have a very special embryonic origin. And because of this special designation, they arise from what's called the branchial arches. Branchial arches give rise to the pharyngeal constrictors, parts of the mandible, and because of this special category during development, they get this designation as special visceral efferent, even though they're still skeletal muscles. So it doesn't matter in the long run, because they're skeletal muscle, just like the skeletal muscle of my face or the skeletal muscle of my hand. They still get neuromuscular junctions, just like every other muscle. But because of this embryology, they're called a different name. So don't worry about it, but I want you to know that you may hear this term. So the striated muscle of the vagus is going to often be referred to as a special branchial stuff. The visceral parasympathetic, or the visceral motor of the vagus, is amazing in the sense that it comes down, remember, behind the great vessels. It innervates the heart, the lungs, all aspects of the GI tract down to the splenic flexure of the colon. So all of your abdominal viscera below your larynx, below your voice box, all through your thorax and abdomen, down to this splenic flexure here in the colon, all innervated by the vagus nerve. That's why it's called the wanderer, because it goes all over the place. In the next section, we'll talk about the sensory component of the vagus nerve.